Hey everybody, I am so happy to be here making this video for you all, and I wanted to talk about some very practical ways to deal with getting through a bad day. I've had somebody ask me this before, Renee, tell me, make a video about what do I do when I'm having a bad day. So I am here, and a quote that I wanted to offer to you, I just learned about this quote yesterday, and it goes, try to be a rainbow in someone else's cloud. So if you're having a bad day and you're watching this, I'm so glad you're here, and I hope I can be a little bit of a shining light in a dark cloud for you. So the things I'm going to be mentioning are things that I have done to help myself when I'm going through a really bad day. And sometimes if it's just an all-out knockdown crap day, or if it's just some really difficult bumps that you're dealing with, or somewhere in between. So the first thing I want you to do is to kind of take perspective. And when we're in that dark cloud, it can be difficult to get perspective. So that's why I'm here to remind you. Kind of check in with yourself. Are you tired? How did you sleep last night? Are you hungry? Are you overworked? What is going on in your physical body that might be affecting your mindset? So let's say, and this happened to me recently, I had a day that was so full and it was just like bam, bam, bam. The whole day was just totally packed. And I was just going and going and going and keeping this really high level of energy. And then the next morning I woke up feeling tired. I knew right off the bat I'm at a deficit because yesterday I did like more than a day's worth of work crammed into one day. And I knew I kind of started off the next day not with a full tank of gas, so to speak. So notice, is it something like that going on where it's just like compounding stress and compounding lack of sleep and tiredness? And that can just really make your outlook on everything really skewed. So put it in that perspective. Make sure if you're hungry, you know, low blood sugar and tired is not a good combination. Do you need to take care of your body? What do you need to do? The next thing is don't judge yourself. So if you are a high achiever, like me, and you expect a lot out of yourself and you're used to a high level of productivity and you're a go-getter, and then you have this bad day and you don't feel like doing anything, you're not feeling good, you're not feeling confident, you're not feeling inspired, you're just feeling kind of negative and kind of blue. Don't judge yourself for feeling that way. It can be really easy to be like, oh, darn it, I'm not like putting out the level of work and the level of output that I'm used to doing. Recognize the situation for what it is and say, you know what, I'm really tired, if that's the case for you, or I'm just not feeling it today, but I'm gonna do the best that I can. I'm going to honor myself, honor how I'm feeling, and I know, you know, that this will pass and tomorrow will be a better day, but I'm not going to beat myself up. I'm not going to get down on myself. I'm not going to add to that negativity by keep, you know, telling myself negative things that aren't true. So don't judge yourself. Let that go. Let yourself be and leave yourself alone. Don't pick on yourself. Next thing is to be loving to yourself. This goes along with the last point I mentioned about not judging yourself. What do you need to kind of get yourself through this time? Do you need to be alone and just have some me time? Do you need to call up a friend? Do you want to allow yourself to indulge in your favorite comfort food or drink? Do you need a good hard workout to get some stress out? Do you want to just be alone and listen to some beautiful music or read a book, take a hot bath? Whatever it is that, you know, is nurturing to you. Let yourself do that. I know we all have busy lives and lots of obligations, but let yourself, as much as you can, carve out a little bit of time to take care of yourself. I did this for myself recently where I just put on some like beautiful music and I said, you know what, Renee, you're just gonna do what you can today. And it's not gonna be like the crazy day yesterday where you were like over the top productive, but you're just gonna do one thing. And so I told myself, look at the situation for what it is. Don't let yourself be sucked into those negative and dark feelings because they're not true and they're just temporary and it's just your monkey mind kicking out stuff. And I said, just pick one thing to do right now. Forget the whole to-do list. Just focus on what's right in front of you. And that can really help you to kind of scale down, get grounded, and just, you know, kind of take things as you can. And the next thing, acknowledge what is going right. and acknowledge what you do have. So if we're having a bad day and we're just sort of in this negative land, what we need to do is start to shift our focus from what focusing on what we don't have, what's going wrong, maybe how bad we're feeling at that moment, to start to look at and say, hey, you know, actually, that's not the whole picture. I actually have some really good things going on, and list them out to yourself. Tell yourself, have this little conversation with yourself. Well, I got this going right and this going right, and I have this and this, and that makes my life wonderful. So start to shift your focus, not on what is lacking, to what is going right. And that can really do a lot for bringing your mood up and helping you get out of a funk. And the last thing I want to remind you is to use this as an opportunity to reparent yourself. So if you learned growing up in these situations to be very hard on yourself and to judge yourself and to just say, oh, I'm a loser, I'm not getting all this stuff done, you're just beating yourself up, or you're feeling down because you're not working at the level you want or because you're not feeling better, use this time to turn around all that stuff that you learned, that old programming, and say, no, I'm going to reparent myself. I am responsible for what I feel, and I'm responsible for what I do with my feelings, and I'm not going to use myself as a punching bag. Everything will work out. It always does, and I will get through this. Tomorrow is another day, and I'm just going to take really good care of myself. I'm going to be loving and nurturing to myself. Give yourself that love and that nurturing that maybe you never got. This is a perfect opportunity to take care of that. Tell yourself nice things. Be easy on yourself. I once had a yoga teacher who, at the end of the class, when you do your final relaxation, she said to kind of like, okay, take a moment to get all your fidgets out and then just relax and lay there and close your eyes and breathe. And she said, please leave yourself alone. So I'm going to tell you that same thing right here. Leave yourself alone. Don't pick on yourself. Do what is loving and nurturing for yourself. You deserve that, and it is okay to give yourself that care. It is important that you do, and your life depends on it, because if you don't take care of yourself, you can't continue to go out into the world and take care of others in your job or in your family or your pets or whomever you are in contact with. So that's it, just a quick video. I hope I was able to add a little bit of brightness to your day. That is my intention and my hope. If you have any questions or comments, please share it for me below the video. And again, I so appreciate you watching, and I'll talk to you soon.